Today's new story name is A Memorial to Uncle Tom. George Shelby returned home with the news of Uncle Tom's death. Aunt Joy was waiting anxious for her husband. She had saved all her salary to give them to him. He wanted no Polly at all. She was just a baby when he left and now she is 5 years old. Hearing the wagon arrive, both Mr. Shelby and Aunt Jolly ran out. George sat down alone. He put his arms around Aunt Jolly and told her, "Poor Aunt Joy, I would have given all my fortune to bring him back, but he has gone to a better country." Mr. Shelby exclaimed, but there was no response from Aunt Joy. She went back to the room and brought the money. She told Mr. Shelby, "Here, I do not want to see this money again. I knew he would get murdered." Mr. Shelby put her arms around her. Aunt Joy broke down and sobbed her heart out. "Oh, Mrs., forgive me. My heart is broken. I know," Mr. Shelby said tenderly. Tears streaming down from her own eyes, "I cannot heal your heart, but God will." Later, when they had quieted down, George told him of his visit. A month later, he called all his servants in front of his house. He came out with a bundle of papers, called each of them, and gave them their certificates of freedom, administered of and sobs from them. They were very happy, but some of them wanted to continue to work with them. "My friends," George said, "there is no need for you to leave. You people are free, but we need you all. You can work for me, for which you will get wages. If ever I am in debt, none of you can be sold. You will be free to go everywhere you wish. I shall help in teaching you the right of free men and women, and pray to God to help me in my task." They knelt down and prayed. George asked them, "Do you remember our good old Uncle Tom?" He then told them of his death and how he had sent his love to all of them. George said that he had vowed on his grave that he would never own a slave. He told all of them, "So when you are happy and celebrating, please remember him, for the freedom that you got is a lot due to his sacrifice. Please pay it back in kindness to his wife and children. When you see Uncle Tom's cabin, think of your freedom. Let it be a memory for all of you to follow his example, and be a honest and loving man like Uncle